to another edition of Tri-Ship Wrestling. On today's program, you'll see newcomer Bobby Eaton, Ron Slinker, a special Southeastern Tag Team title match with hair and mask on the line, as the champions, the Manchurians, defend against the Matador and Troy T. Tyler. We'll be talking to Ron Slinker, the Great Mephisto, and we'll be discussing a new and unusual type of wrestling. Plus, in action, Don Diamond, Killer Carl Cox, Dutch Mantell, and others. Now let's join former wrestling star and your host, Les Thatcher, for Tri-Cities Southeastern Championship Wrestling.
Hello and welcome once again to Tri-Cities Southeastern Championship Wrestling. We've got a fine action-packed program for you today. We'll be seeing Don Diamond in action for his first start on our television program. You also might know that the Great Mephisto was, in fact, fined $500 for the alleged throwing of the fire in the parking lot incident. Certainly a small sum by many people's standards, my own included. I feel that the man should have had to pay quite a bit more. This seemingly just a slap on the wrist. Also, Steve Travis is a new Mid-American Heavyweight Champion. Steve, a fine young athlete, proving that he is of championship caliber. And on Wrestling News Update today, we'll be talking to the Great Mephisto about a new and unusual type of match, about the wrestlers in his stable, and about his feelings on this fining by Bob Geigel and the governing body of the $500. Also in action, newcomer Bobby Eaton on the program, Killer Carl Cox, and Terry Taylor. A great array of stars, a great lineup. We want you to stay with us for every action-packed minute. And right now, let's go to Alan Williams for the introductions of our first match.
First match on Southeastern Championship Wrestling is one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Weighing 231 pounds from Florida, Don Diamond. His opponent from Tennessee, weighing 220 pounds, Rick Connors.
Don Diamond making his first television start here in the Southeastern area against Rick Connors. And, of course, Diamond has won the hearts of many of the fans here. Fine-looking young athlete and certainly impressive in that ring. Diamond blocking as Connors attempting to hook that leg. Diamond is behind for the waist lock, and Connors trying to free himself. They hit the ropes, and referee Tommy Weathers calls for the break. Of course, a lot of you fans are probably wondering what has transpired between Brett Sawyer, and Dutch Mantell. Well, Mantell did beat Brett Sawyer two consecutive falls in 10 minutes, but invited him to stay for a third, and he paid him $500. And Sawyer hung in there tough, and young Brett is will be the recipient of that $500. He's here today and hopes to collect that money. Diamond in for the single leg and the sweep to take the other leg down, and he's got him on the hook. And again, into the ropes, calling for the break. Connors with a double leg. Don Diamond, a very aggressive, offensive wrestler, carries the battle to his opponent. And we've seen some good wrestling between Connors and Diamond here. Some good reversals, good hooks. Collar and elbow. Connors with a headlock to takedown. A reversal by Diamond to the head scissor. Connor out, head up, and Diamond up right along with him. Connors hooks the arm now. Don Diamond steps through, takes him down with the legs. And on the canvas, they are in the ropes once more. Diamond coming off and goes for the arm whip, but reversed by Connors. Look at here. Good one. Good move by Don Diamond. And he's got a three count. Don Diamond reversing the reversal by Rick Connors and comes up with the win. A beautiful move by the young man out of Florida. And of course, we had told you at the top of the program about some interesting facts. We'll be talking about those in just a moment. But first, a message of interest to you wrestling fans. We'd like to remind you that Southeastern Wrestling returns to Hindman, Kentucky on Saturday, April the 26th, on Monday, April the 28th in Jenkins, Kentucky, and we return to Hattiesburg on Monday, May the 5th. With me, Dutch Mantell, and I know, Dutch, the big thing in your mind right now is to retrieve that television trophy.
You know, the television trophy was stolen from me in the first place by Troy T. Tyler, A.O.T. Troy T. Tyler gave you that name, didn't he? Well, if he gave you the name, you should get rid of it. Well, anyway, I don't like the name LT. I wish you'd call yourself Les Thatcher. I wish you'd tell Troy T. Tyler to call yourself Troy T. I'm going to swing your way one time, my friend. And you and that little stooge of yours, Brett Sawyer, are going to pay the dues for stealing my television trophy. You know, if they'd done it on the street, they'd be in jail. But since they've done it on Southeastern Championship Wrestling, I think they can get it. They think they can get away with murder. Well, you can't get away with murder with me because I'm a man. I'm my own man. I've always done it my way, and I'm going to do it my way. Troy T, I'm coming your way, friend.
The comments of Dutch Mantell. Joining me, promoter Bob Polk, Steve Travis, and the Matador. And I think, Bob, to start with, congratulations are in order for this young man, Steve Travis.
Yes, indeed. He's the Midwestern champion. We had him planned for a TV match today. He's not able to be here. We want to congratulate him on that and say that shortly we'd like to sign him for a title match here.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Polk. Les, thank you so much. I certainly appreciate it. And I tell you, I feel like a barnyard rooster fixing to crow. But this new title that I won, the Mid-America Championship, is definitely the finest thing that's happened to me so far, and I'm just sorry that I can't stay and fulfill my obligation today, but I've got to defend that title, and but I'll be back next week.
So as soon as you finish this interview, you're going
to Chattanooga to defend that title down there.
Well, Steve, again, congratulations and good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Long and illustrious reign.
Take care.
And, of course, Bob, I think the big thing now is Mephisto has been fined $500, but I don't think everyone's in agreement with that being the proper amount.
No, that's the case. Last week we said we would have a ruling on this situation, and what happened was Bob Geigel and the governing body did fine Mephisto $500. Now, there were some extenuating circumstances there. I'm not necessarily happy with that, whether it's a slap on the wrist, you know, that's a bone of contention, too, but...
$500.
Well,
what if I did something like that?
Well, again,
they'd probably put me under the jail. $500 a slap on the hand.
I agree with you. Perhaps it should have been more, but as we'll see, Jerry Roberts was supposed to be in Kansas City, and
well,
he was not
on
there.
His way. It's not my fault he didn't get there.
Anyway, he was not there to represent your side, and Mephisto, of course, had an attorney there, and there's some question I think we're going to see here about, you know, the match, and anyway, the ruling is $500, and whether you and I are happy is not important.
Well, of course, the segment of tape has been freed for us to air once again, so quickly, let's see what took place 2 weeks ago when Ron Slinker entered the ring and the great Mephisto was there. And, of course, here we see the Matador in action. It was a match, Matador, between you and Jerry Roberts and the Manchurians.
That's right. You see, they tie me in the ropes right here. Mephisto's taking off his butt and beats me like a doll, which I didn't like.
And, of course, in a moment, we're going to see Ron Slinker hit that ring, Bob, and as we see it here, the Manchurians bringing him into the ring proper. But this is not what we're really concerned with, but in a moment, we'll see Slinker breaking free,
right,
battling all three men.
Here's a situation where Mephisto's attorneys claim that perhaps Slinker dropped this. Again, you were not represented there, Matador, and they came out with the $500.
We see Slinker going after Mephisto here now, and now we're seeing the Manchurians pull him off, putting his arms down, and watch closely around the face of Ron Slinker as Mephisto comes toward him. And there it is.
All right. $500, we're not happy, but, you know, that issue's going on. Now,
of course, there is a match taking place here today, which is a very unusual match for television.
A very important match here on television today. It will be a TV title match. And one thing with the Southeastern...
You mean tag team title?
Tag team title match. And what we've got here... situation with you and you is that the Manchurians will be in it. Their title will be on the line. If they lose a fall, their manager will have to shave his head.
Right here on television.
Right here on television.
Right here at our desk.
If you lose a fall, you must unmask on television. There's some controversy here about a match you lost several weeks ago where you did not take your mask off. So today on television...
What do you mean I didn't take it off? Did you see the match?
Well, I was there. I saw the match.
These people didn't want me to take it off. That's
right.
What they saw.
They may not want it, but it goes without saying, if you lose it today, you take your mask off. However, if this gentleman loses right here, his hair comes off.
There ain't no controversy about it, my friend. If I lose, I'll shave my head. If my man loses, he'll unmask.
Okay.
There ain't no big problem.
Title match, Mephisto's people lose. Hope his hair comes. You lose your mask.
I'll lose my hair.
All right, Joe.
Right here on television.
You got my word right here. If I lose, I'll shave my head right here.
That'll be the next match coming up, but first we've got this important interview. With me, Don Diamond and Ron Slinker. We'll talk to them in just a moment, but again, I'd like to remind you that on Saturday, April the 26th, Southeastern Wrestling returns to Hyman, Kentucky, the old Hyman High School at 8:30 p.m. And also on Monday, April the 28th, Southeastern Wrestling will be in Jenkins, Kentucky at the Jenkins High School at 8:30 p.m. And wrestling returns to Hazard, Kentucky, Memorial Gym on Monday, May the 5th, Bell time there will be 8:30 p.m. But of course, gentlemen, we're looking forward to you being on all these cards. Don, before we talk to you, Ron, of course, the people are aware of the burn and the fact now that Mephisto was fined a paltry $500 for the incident.
Well, let me tell you something. As people know out there, I'm a man who stands behind everything I say. And believe me, Mephisto, no matter what it takes, or where it is, or where it happens, you can bet your life, my friend, that you're going to pay for this a thousandfold. Anywhere, anytime, any place that you want to meet me, my friend, anywhere, just let me know. Let the promoters know. Let the people know, because the people come tell me, and they're going to be witness and pay tribute to the fact that you are going to leave this country just the way you come in, a poor man.
Well, Don, you've been doing a bit of teaming, a tag team wrestling with Steve Travis, who was just crowned the new Mid-American singles champion, so the two of you should be putting together a fine combination.
That's right, Les. You know, I just want to give all my congratulations to Steve. He's a great personal friend and a great champion, too, and he just captured that Mid-America title, and that's a good feather in his cap. Another feather we're going after is those Southeastern tag team titles, and hopefully someday, somewhere down the line, we can get the promoters to get us a match. Not really, it doesn't matter anywhere in Tennessee, really, as long as we can get the match and get those Manchurians in the ring and have the match, and I'm sure we'll come out victors, because with a partner like Steve, you just can't lose. He's a gentleman, he's an athlete, and he's one heck of a close friend.
Don, thank you for joining us. The comments of Don Diamond and Ron Slinker, you'll be seeing them there in your area very soon.
Matches one fall with a 15-minute time limit for the Southeastern Tag Team Championship. With a combined weight of 520 pounds from Manchuria, the Manchurians, managed by the great Mephisto. Their opponents with a combined weight of 486 pounds from parts unknown, the Matador. And from Florida, Troy T. Tyler.
Here we go, our special Southeastern Tag Team title match. The Manchurians defending their belt. And if they lose that title here on television, then the great Mephisto will join us here at the desk to shave his head. If the Matador loses a fall for his team, he will unmask right here at our desk. And if Troy T. Tyler is the man that happens to lose a fall for his team, he will shave his head. So more than just the titles riding on this one, Alan. A lot of pride and ego.
A lot of pride.
Troy T. Tyler with a flying mare and a rabbit punch across the back of the Manchurian. Of course, the Manchurians are tag team champions. And Tyler and the Matador will have to carry the battle through them.
That's true. This is going to be a tough match because a lot is at stake. It's for the hair and the mask.
Tyler and the Manchurian, collar elbow once again into the ropes, jogging. And a change of blows and a good right hand by Troy T. Body slam. Tempo, and he's carrying the offense.
He's got the momentum right now.
He sure does. The tag goes to Manchurian number two, the bigger of the two by a little bit in height and in weight. Troy T with a kick to the midsection, that headlock, and a counter to that right fist on the head. And the Manchurian got by the Matador on the outside. And so far, the Manchurian has been in any type of offense.
The Matador, I can see from right over here, is anxious to get in the ring. He wants to get in there and have a piece of it.
He's psyched up, chafing at the bit, Al.
Sure is.
Arm whip by Tyler. Gets his man with a clothesline elbow there. Dropping that single elbow, and Troy T trying for the body press. A two count, and the Manchurian out. Mephisto noticeably upset by the fact that his Manchurians have been unable to control Tyler thus far.
Well, that's true. Tyler wants to keep his hair. I don't blame him.
A series of kicks and chops by both Tyler and the Manchurians. Tyler into the eyes. And he's going to battle him here. Move for move. Troy T sends the Manchurian head first into that turnbuckle. And Mephisto moving down the ring apron to try and give some instructions to his man. Of course, also a diversionary tactic by Mephisto, because he feels maybe Tyler will come toward him and leave the Manchurian alone.
That's true. You never can. A lot of times the Manchurians will do it.
Tyler moving out of the way and right back at the Manchurian. Manchurian in control now. Throws Troy to Tyler outside the ring. He'll have a 10 count on the floor. The Manchurian and is going to work outside on 42. There you see it, taking head first into that ring post. And the Matador now down to cover his partner and try and keep Mephisto and the Manchurian away.
That shot against the pole obviously hurt Troy T, and he's having a lot of trouble getting up off the floor.
Stunned him badly, and we're trying to get a look here to see if Troy T can make it back in that ring. The Manchurian goes after him once again. Tyler appears to be lacerated. The Manchurian again kicking him from the outside, and the legal man brings him back in and throws that shot. Tyler kicks him away, and yes, Tyler is lacerated, and he goes to work on it. Of course, all four men having a lot to lose and a lot to gain from winning or losing this match. Sets him up, throws that back drop on him. Hits the other one and nails him in the midsection. Troy G comes through, answering the outside, and the Matador takes control. The Matador opening up, Alan.
He sure is. He's got a lot of time to rest and watch what's going on. He can't take it anymore.
They're double teaming on him, Matador now. The tag was made, and the first man moves in. Yes, he did. That'll take the wind out of your sails, and he's saved by Troy T. Tyler. The tag once again, the Manchurian is giving the fresh man in. And then double chop, the body press, and Tyler moves in to save again. Tyler coming out to go after Francisco. And that diving shot on the Matador there, Troy T. moves in to grab it. Moving down that apron after Troy T. Matador taking over on the Manchurian. Another shot. A kick to the midsection. And both Matador and the Manchurian slowed down. Winded.
Both teams are really worn down here. It's going to be who can hold up the longest to stand.
They opened up fast. Yes, they did.
Back here at the end.
Matador trying to stay on his feet. Mephisto pounds him in across the back, drives him in, and look at here, Troy G goes after Mephisto. Tyler pounding on the manager outside the ring. Tyler pounding on Mephisto.
Turned into a ball.
Outside the ring, it has one man cheering to Mephisto, Troy G. Tyler. Pounding away on him. Matador is having his problems keeping the Manchurian at bay in that ring. He's going to his corner, trying to make a tag, but no Troy T. No Tyler. The Matador asking his partner, where are you? And shoves Tyler, brings him in the ring. Apparently, the Matador had thought that Tyler had abandoned him, but he was unable to power slam.
The Matador just didn't know what was going on, Wes.
The power dive. And the Matador, wait a minute, wait, somebody,
wait.
No, this is wrong, no, this should, the Matador feeling that Tyler had left him, got into an altercation with his partner, we ought to, Tyler was pinned, but I don't believe at this point he should be the man to suffer the consequences from that, but let's,
Tyler Matador thought that, Troy T let him down, and he just couldn't see. Didn't know what was going on.
That was not the case. Troy T had gone after Mephisto and the other Manchurian down the outside of the ring, and the Matador trying to make the tag had no one to tag. And apparently felt that Tyler had left, and when he did come back to the ring apron, the Matador lit into him. Tempers had flared. They were certainly short at that point. But we ought to try and get the Matador back out here because I feel that you know, something here has got to be straight.
Les, I'm going to go look for
right.
It. I'll be right back.
Troy, what can I tell you?
Listen, I know
you're going to say that you don't think you should have to shave your head, and I agree with you wholeheartedly. You should not have to shave your head. I don't feel I try not to take sides in a situation like this, but I feel that your partner was wrong and that there's no reason whatsoever that you should have to be made to do this. Now, wait, I understand. Now, I, I,
don't feel that in the situation that the Matador brought you in without you in?
Man, let me tell you, man. Let me tell you. Let me tell you. I don't know what in the world happened to my man, the Matador. But I'm a man of my word. I stood out here not long, 5 minutes ago. I told the people here in Knoxville, if I lose, I would shave my head. I lost, however. Hey, I don't know. I need somebody to check with the Matador. I don't know what in the world took place. But I will say this. When I was a little bitty boy, I lied one time to one of my friends. And he told me, my mama told me, she said, boy, she said, don't you ever lie to nobody. She said, because when you lie, she said, the good Lord up above knows when you're lying. She said, if I don't know it, she said, the man upstairs will know it. So I told the people right here that I would shave my head. So that's what I will do.
Well, I don't think it's necessary, and I want to reiterate here once again that I think this man, no financial gain, should not be. No, Troy, no, really now, this is not necessary. Troy, think about what you're doing. It's not necessary to do this. Troy? I don't know.
I told the people that I would shave my head. I don't know what the Matador did.
I don't want to take sides here, but I feel the Matador, if anyone, should be taking his mask off, that this man should not be forced to do what, and in my years in this profession, I've never seen a man. He's not being held as you. He's not. No monetary gain for him whatsoever. What else can I say? We'll be back in just a moment. Once again, a reminder that Southeastern Wrestling returns to Hyman, Kentucky, the old Hyman High School gym, bell time, 8:30 p.m. on Saturday, April the 26th. And Southeastern Wrestling will be in Jenkins, Kentucky, the Jenkins High School gym, on Monday, April the 28th. And we'll be back at Hazard's Memorial Gym on Monday, May the 5th, with a super Southeastern Wrestling lineup. With me right now, Troy T. Tyler, the current Southeastern Television Champion. And Troy, the fans have just witnessed what happened in the tag team match, the fact that you have shaved your head. And still, I personally feel that this was not necessary. I know you're a man of your word. I've got to admire you for that. But I feel that in this case, you had no business having to fulfill the stipulations of the match.
You know, like you see it, I'm very down in the dumps last night. You know, it's like coming home and finding somebody in the bed with your wife. You know, that's what it's like. What happened to you, Matador? What you did to me? You come talking, telling all the people that you couldn't find me, that I'm laying out on the floor. I'm out there trying to fight the battle, my friend. What happened? You left me. You fed me to the lions. Throw Troy T. Tyler to the lion den. But that's all right. I'm going to have my chance again at you, boy. Let me tell you something about Troy T. Tyler. I'm panther quick and leather tough. I figured that I've been pushing up. I have a dream that I'll hold to my dying breath. I'll search for my soul and gamble with death. The Matador, your day is coming. Your day is coming, my friend, to look like this. No, this ain't no pretty sight. You know it ain't no pretty sight. I'm still bleeding. But let the blood flow like red wine. Let it flow. I'm going to go get me a blood transfusion. And I'm coming back. Matador, I'm coming after your booty, boy. I'm coming after you, Dutch Mantell, who I took the trophy from. I've still got some things to settle with you, Killer Carcass. But Matador, you are number one. You are number one on my list, my friend. You are number one. You're the cause of my face looking. You know, I wasn't pretty to start with. I never said that. I never was pretty to start with, but I got news for you, Matador. I'm going to get you, my friend.
The comments of Troy T. Tyler, the Southeastern Television Champion.
Ball with a 15-minute time limit, weighing 135 pounds from South America, the Beast. His opponent, weighing 233 pounds from Huntsville, Alabama, Bobby Eaton.
Bobby Eaton, the Beast. Both these gentlemen making their first start on Southeastern Wrestling Television. The Beast out of South America, a very aggressive, tough grappler. And Bobby comes with high credentials. This young gentleman has held several regional titles, and this is my first time to get a look at him, but I've heard from other wrestlers, promoters, that this young gentleman is certainly a fine athlete. Right now, Eaton with that hammerlock on the Beast. Applying the pressure. The Beast with the reversal. He comes up with a hammerlock. Eaton right back at him on his reverse.
The elbow by the Beast frees him from Bobby Eaton. Eaton down, missing the hip lock on the return trip. Arm drag, take down the arm bar, and Bobby Eaton in control. Eaton with that arm bar now, as you notice, hooking his leg through and grapevining the leg of the Beast. Now freeing that particular leg, but applying more pressure to the shoulder and elbow joint. The Beast, the air goes to punch Eaton, and Eaton has moved and comes right back up with the arm bar. Young man moves well, very, very fast in that ring. Eaton now straddling his man, putting his weight, applying that pressure on the arm bar. A rabbit punch by the Beast, and another, and Eaton hooks him, takes him over with the arm drag, and maintains control. The Beast again, with a handful of air, pulls Eaton down, tearing at the eyes now. Dives Bobby head first into that top turnbuckle, flying there into the center ring, and comes up with a reverse chin lock. The Beast grabs a handful of hair, dives over, and takes Eaton with him, using the laces of his boot to creep down along the eyes. And Eaton retaliates with a couple of well-placed right hands. Beals his man cross-ring. Stepping over the drop kick. And the Beast out on the count of one. Eaton right on top of him, but the Beast again going to the eyes. Drapes Bobby across that center strand of ropes. Rabbit punches. And the Beast now mounting an offense. The chop staggers Big Bob. And Eaton right back with a double chop of his own. And a looping right hand spins the big man from South America around. Eaton comes up with a reverse chin lock now. Eaton applying the pressure now. The Beast showing glimpses of good wrestling, good basic wrestling, but elects to cut the corners, use the hair, the eyes to his advantage. Windmills the arm of Bobby Eaton, crashes him into that turnbuckle, and moves in to choke his man. Referee Tommy Weathers calling for the break. Eaton has been slowed down now by the Beast. A kick to the midsection by Bobby, and an elbow moves him out of trouble and out of that corner. And as the Beast comes off those ropes, it's Eaton stinging him with that shot to the midsection. The arm bar, and Bobby, showing that experience, continues to go back to that arm. I'm not aware of what Eaton's favorite hold may be at this point, but it may possibly have to do with the arm because it continually goes back to the arm. But right now, the Beast again breaking the eyes with the laces of his wrestling boot. Moving in now, and referee Weathers calling for the break. The Beast with a rabbit punch down across the back. A chop staggers Bobby Eaton, drives him into the corner, and Eaton's out with a shot, but not enough to stop the big man. Eaton swings again, misses, comes up with a headlock, and they're exchanging punches now. The Beast comes with a tackle, catches Eaton again. Eaton catches him on the shoulder, airplane spin by Bobby Eaton. Diving back on top of his man, hooks him. And you've got a winner. Bobby, the winner. Over the Beast.
Les, excuse me a minute.
The winner, Bob Focus.
Excuse me just a minute. I've got Troy and Ron wants to say something.
Look, not
You tried to stop this man. He went to the bathroom, locked himself in the bathroom. Troy, why did you do this for, man? What's wrong with you?
I want
to
kill all the people here. Troy T. Tyler is a man of his word. Matador, you let me down. You are Judas. You are Judas the professionalist. I told the people right here, I thought no way in the world that Troy T. Tyler would lose his hair. It is bleached, that's true, but you know my hair meant a lot to me. But you know, let me tell you something, Les Thatcher. I want to tell you something, too, promoter. I want to tell all the people. Troy T. Tyler, 275 pounds of roping, stomping, graveyard destruction, is a man of his word. I have been low. I've did a lot of things, but it's something I have never did, Les Thatcher, in my life, is betray a friend. When I was bone standing up and talking back, my daddy was a green-eyed jack down at the car wash. You know what I'm talking about? I know what it is to be low. I know what it is to be poor. But Matador, you are a low-life dog. You betrayed me. You are a Judas. You are a Judas. You are a Judas, a professional wrestler. I shaved my head back there in the back room. All the guys back here trying to stop me. Matador, I don't know where you run to like a rat after cheese. But I got news for you, boy. I'm going to black both of your eyes, shave your head, pull the mask off, and show all the people your bald head. You got a bald spot too, boy. And I'm going to show all the people what it looks like, because I know what it looks like. You cost me my hair. I didn't have to shave it. I could have got out of it. I could have broken run like he did. But I ain't that kind of a person. I stood right here and looked you right dead in your eyeballs, and I told you, people out there may think I'm crazy for doing it, but that's the way I feel, Daddy. That's the way I feel. That's the way I was born. That's the way I'll always be. I told all the people that I would shave my head, and that's exactly what I did. Matter of fact, I'm after your booty, boy.
Well, all I can say is Wes, he's going to get his chance. He'll get his chance.
Bob, thank you. I can't say that I feel he should have shaved his head, but I admire Troy T. Tyler for being a man of his word. There's certainly no doubt about that at all. Right now, we're going to Wrestling News Update. We're pleased to have with us today on Wrestling News Update, world champion Harley Race. And Harley, I'm very glad that you were able to come back to the area, and especially glad to have you here today, because there's a couple of things I'd like to discuss with you. Of course, Austin Idol very upset with us for several reasons, one of them being us showing the tape of your involvement with he and Tommy Rich on an Atlanta television program some 5 or 6 weeks ago.
Let me say this to you, Les. Every time I'm around you and every time I'm in this particular area, the word Austin Idol, the man, keeps being thrown up to me. I have no dealings with the Austin Idol whatsoever. Sure, the man's upset over viewing this film. Wouldn't you be? Wouldn't anyone else be? Wouldn't some of your prima donna balloon heads that you got around here that you're Mr. Nice Guy, wouldn't they be upset if you picked out one particular film where they look bad and you showed it and showed it and showed it?
Well, let's
I'm upset along with him.
Well, Harley, to refresh all of our
I don't need
band
my
as well, let's
refresh.
Take just a brief look again at the match between Austin Idol and Tommy Rich in Atlanta, Georgia. I think, Harley, this proves that there was some type of alliance between you and Austin Idol, because he and you have involved yourself in this match with he and Tommy Rich.
Les, let me clarify this once and for all. When you see injustice being done, it doesn't take an alliance between two people to want to stop it. It doesn't take an alliance amongst any human beings to want to stop someone that's absolutely wrong when they continue to be that way and they continue to act the way that Tommy Rich has acted, the way that Wrestling Number Two has acted, the way that the list could go on and on and on. They go in the ring and they pretend to go along with the rules. But you take a good close look sometime and see exactly who does.
Let me ask you a question. Do you have Austin Idol as a traveling companion on your
trip? What?
Do you have Austin Idol as a traveling companion?
You're as ridiculous, Thatcher, as what you're sitting here trying to ask.
The second question, is he on your payroll, Harley?
I got no one on my payroll. I have a hard enough time just surviving myself. You know, times are tough now. They're very tough. You know, it's hard running around the world paying these big, enormous airline fares, this, that, and the other. You know, I'm having a hard time making a go of it myself, let alone having someone on my payroll.
Why I ask this, because the match with you and Tommy Rich for the World Championship was signed here. It was last night. We have a film of that match, and I'd like
another film?
Another film. I'd like to look at this and tell you exactly why I ask you if Austin and I will travel with you. Let's roll the film. World Champion Harley Race defending against Wildfire Tommy Rich. And Harley, it was quite a battle.
That's right, it was. It was a tremendous battle. But as you will see, if you haven't edited it all out and made it look one way and one way only, that I carried the match to him all the way. I beat on him like you'd beat on a drum for something like 35, 40 minutes.
Well, where we picked the match up here, about 20, 25 minutes into the contest, both of you lacerated quite badly, and as we can see, both of you worn down from the physical exertion.
You see what I'm telling you? Take a look at this here. How many straight shots did the man throw, and how many times have you saw the referee warn him or do anything at all about it? Now, you talk about prejudice. You talk about an alliance between two people. Now, if that's not an alliance between a referee and a wrestler, what would you call it? He's beating on me with absolute fist. There's no way around. How do you camouflage that? It surprises me that you even showed it.
Fists were used on a part of both parties, and of course, we did have
to. You saw me throw one fist yet?
Not as we've picked the film up here. No, Harley, we have not. We see you grabbing a headlock here.
That is a very legal headlock, right?
Right. The drop kick by Rich, and you become entangled
here
in the ropes.
I am tangled in the ropes. Did the referee try to get me out? No. Looky here. Pounding on me again, and you're talking
well,
about...
Well, here the referee is putting Rich back, and he does come and make an effort. In fact, goes outside the ring to make the effort to get you out.
Why
of the
don't
rope.
He disqualify the man? He's
and
got
here
the
we see, as you move, Rich drop kicks the referee. Now, both of you somewhat dazed.
What would they have done if that had been me hitting the referee? They would have disqualified me that fast. You know it as well as you're sitting there. Tell the truth, Thatcher. Don't live in a pretense world of all right and justice.
And, of course, at this point, Rich had small-packaged you, cradled you, and here we see a man in wrestling tights. Watch here with that knee, which is very familiar. He's wearing a mask, but look at the wrestling boots that he's wearing. Look at the build. The belt coming from around his waist, Harley. He's putting the figure four on Tommy Rich, trying to belt those legs together as we saw Austin Idol do it in Atlanta just moments ago from that television clip. Now explain to me who this man is and wearing a T-shirt.
I have no idea whatsoever who this man is. I've never saw him before in my life. I'll probably never ever see him again. I have no
idea. Why would he interfere in your match? Why would he put the figure
four
on Tommy
Rich? Because, as I was telling you, he stood there and watched this injustice happen for 10 minutes, a man beating on me in every way humanly possible.
But
no right man in with justice in his heart.
To the best of my knowledge, this man, whoever he might have been, was not under contract to wrestle on this particular card. And
I don't even know if he was a wrestler.
Interfere in a world title match, Harley. It's a very important match for you as a champion, as well as Tommy Rich as a challenger here.
Certainly.
The thing has gone haywire here. Wrestlers coming in trying.
Who's this guy coming in?
Troy T. Tyler.
Who's this big fat balloon coming in here now?
Troy T. Tyler. That's Dusty's protege. I'm sure you must know about this gentleman.
What's he doing there?
Well, he's come into, it was a two-on-one situation with this masked man, whatever you want to call him. I would like to call him Austin Idol because there's quite a resemblance there, Harley.
Why? Do you think the Austin Idol would be dumb enough to walk in with it written on his chest? You've got to be as goofy as these people are around here. They're all screaming Austin Idol. I went out last night and had a couple of short little nips, and everyone was telling me I paid the Austin Idol. Well, let me tell you something, Thatcher. I love jewelry. You know, I love gold. I love the things that money can bring you. I don't want to pay somebody, give it away. I want to use it for myself.
Well, Harley, certainly I appreciate you taking the time. Let me ask you the questions, and I appreciate you giving me some answers to this. I hope it's beneficial to the fans
and
as well.
And I hope these people out here saw justice served the right way.
We won't have the time to show you the clip of Austin Idol and Kevin Sullivan's brother today. We'll show you that next week, but we told you that Austin Idol is mad and incensed. Here's an interview from Austin Idol.
Universal heartthrob is Austin Idol. And frankly, the word has come to us, Austin Idols, you're quite upset about something.
You bet your life, darling, I'm upset about something. You know, there's one thing that I can't stand. And that's for anybody, and I mean anybody, trying to undermine Austin Idol. Bob Polk, the promoter of Southeastern Wrestling in Tennessee, knew full well that I had an injunction, along with my attorneys here, to have a certain piece of film not shown on television. Now, I don't know how he did it. Some way or another, by hook or crook, and I firmly believe it was by crook that he had the film that I deliberately told him, do not show that film on television. Well, he went ahead and showed it anyway. Now, the attorneys from the South that I had representing me are no longer with me. They are fired. But, Polk, I want you to bear one thing in mind, that you and everybody in the administration in Southeastern Wrestling are going to be the ones held responsible for what's going to happen to a certain individual. I will take no claim. I will take no blame. Because of you and your greediness to sell out the Knoxville Coliseum, you will be the one that have to sleep at night, and you and your conscience, you'll have to live with your conscience, Polk, because you are the one who's going to receive all the hate mail, not me, for what's going to happen to an individual that you know what I'm talking about. It's you, Polk.
The man that all this controversy has been built around, the Matador, with me right now, and I think everyone would agree that in this case you should have been the man to unmask. I don't think Tyler did what you thought he did. He did not abandon you.
What do you mean he didn't abandon me? Where was he when I needed him, Les Thatcher? I was there waiting to tag the man. He wasn't even around. Where was he? Troy T. Tyler, where were you? Yeah, this mask might have should have come off, but it's not coming off. You're not taking it off. These people out here are not taking it off, and Troy T. Tyler, it'll be a cold day you know where before you get it off, Beckin. Let me tell you, you were stupid, you're dumb, you're ignorant. You didn't have to shave your head. That just shows how stupid you are.
Just a man of integrity is what it amounts to.
Integrity.
A man of his word, yes, a man of his word.
Ha, man of his word. He's a man of his word, he'll come get this mask.
The comments of the Matador, and he says that if Troy T's a man of his word, he'll come get the mask. That's exactly what Tyler wants to do, and if that match comes up in here, you won't want to miss it. Brett Sawyer, and as I told you earlier in the program, Brett did step in the ring with Dutch Mantell. And of course, in that match, Brett, the Cobra Hole was barred, and Dutch had to beat you two falls within 10 minutes, which he did.
Right.
But then he made another offer to you, and what was that, Brett?
There was 3 to 4 minutes left in the match, and he got down to ringside, and he says, if you can stay another 3-4 minutes, whatever was left in the match, I'll give you $500.
Or he would have to pin you in that period
right,
of time. Is that correct?
Right, correct. And so we went back in the ring, and I did stay. 3 minutes was left in the match, and I'm here to collect my $500, and, you know, it was a tough match. I have a lot of respect for the guy. He's top, and I'm just here to collect my money.
Now you want to see how much respect he's got for you, right? Because you do indeed deserve the $500.
Yes,
you might also say that Brett was, this was about the third time that you had actually been in a professional match, is that correct?
Right. And he's, like I said, he's a top man, and I didn't expect for him to beat me the second time. He did, you know, and it surprised me. I was disappointed. The people was disappointed, but time will tell.
Well, I think that's fair enough. I think we ought to ask Dutch Mantell to come out here and give this young man his $500. Dutch, you do owe...
Okay, wait just a minute. Wait just a minute. I'm going to tell you one thing, Sawyer. You got a lot of guts. You got more guts than I gave you credit for. And I'm going to tell you what. The only reason you got that last 3 minutes because that onion head Troy T. Tyler kept pulling you out of the ring. You couldn't have lasted another 30 seconds. And I'm going to tell you what, Sawyer. I am not paying you $500. I ain't paying you.
Mantell is acting Sawyer after Dutch Mantell. And he has got Brett down. He's got the cover hold on Brett Sawyer. This is the hold that was part of that match. And instead of giving this man $500, he has given this young gentleman quite a thrashing with that cover hold. Sawyer fighting it, but Mantell is hanging on and of course, unscheduled here. He should be paying that man $500. Terry Taylor comes out. Mantell scoots away. Taylor and Don Fulton move out to the ring to help Brett Sawyer, and this certainly uncalled for. Brett Sawyer, let's hope he's not injured too badly. This young man deserves his $500 and then some. Not that much. And now Don Fulton has gotten into it with Dutch Mantell. Mantell pulls Fulton into the ring, and they're going at it. Fulton pounding away at Dutch Mantell. Mantell hooking it. Here comes Killer Carl Fox. Killer Carl Fox moves in to help out Dutch Mantell. And Don Fulton at the mercy of Cox and Mantell. And a brainbuster by Killer Carl Fox drops Don Fulton. Ole Anderson hits the ring. Ole Anderson goes after Killer Carl Fox. And Fox heads for home. For a matter of minutes, Brett Sawyer injured. Possibly by the cobra hole of Dutch Mantell. Don Fulton dropped the brainbuster of Killer Carl Cox. Ole Anderson in to help out. Anderson and the referee now helping Don Fulton. We're having another match here. And if we can get that match in the ring, we'll try and get a report on Don Fulton, on Brett Sawyer. Mantell and Cox creating quite a bit of confusion here. We do have another match going in the ring, and as quickly as we can get that match in, we will get our ring introduction. And here comes Terry Taylor out to wrestle Killer Carl Cox. Here's Alan Williams for the introduction.
Our last match is one fall with time remaining in the program with a combined weight of 491 pounds. It should be Killer Carl Cox, but Killer Carl Cox is going against Terry Taylor.
The bell, and Killer Carl Cox, having already warmed up on John Fulton with that brainbuster, goes to work on young Terry Taylor. Taylor trying to fight back. Cox trying to control him now. Taylor battling back. Cox tearing at Taylor's eye. Shoots him cross-ring into the ropes. Midsection shot as Taylor comes off. Ole Anderson out, cheering Taylor on before that brainbuster can be applied. Killer Carl Cox is pushed off balance, and Terry Taylor comes down on top of him. Ole Anderson now moving back in that ring as Taylor is pitched over the top rope. And it is Killer Carl Cox and Ole Anderson with a shoe. Terry Taylor is doing the match. Ole Anderson with a shoe, pounding at the head of Killer Carl Cox. And we've got pandemonium here. Cox outside that ring, chased there by Anderson for the second time in less than 5 minutes. Terry Taylor awarded the match over Killer Carl Cox, and we'll be back in just a second.
A last reminder, Southeastern Wrestling on Saturday, April the 26th, will return to Hyndman, Kentucky, the old Hyndman High School gym at 8:30 p.m. On Monday, April the 28th, in Jenkins, Kentucky, the Jenkins High School gym at 8:30 p.m. And Southeastern Wrestling returns to Hazards Memorial Gym with a super lineup on Monday, May the 5th, bell time, 8:30 p.m. With me, the manager of the current Southeastern Tag Team Champions, the great Mephisto. And Mephisto, I think everyone feels as I do, that your $500 fine was just a slap on the wrist because of all the problems, medical and physical problems that were incurred by it.
Well, you know, Ron Snicker brought all this upon himself. Now, to repeat myself time and time again, he was the one that brought that mysterious capsule into the ring. I picked it up, during the time that he attacked me. I picked it up, the thing ignited and burned his face. So they seemed fit to fine me $500, which was very unjust. You know, the Arabs are the just and humane people. We don't have to use any sort of illegal weapons, and our history will testify to this in order to win matches. But Ron Slinker was hired by a certain individual to come in and to get rid of the great Mephisto and the Manchurians as fast as he can. You know, he is the former United States professional karate champion. And like I said, he was a hard gun. Everything backfired on him, Alice seen to that. And I was fined $500, but I'm sure that after they find me, if they search their hearts, they'll know that I shouldn't have been fined not a dime.
Before we run out of time, one quick question. How do you feel about this incident with Troy T. Tyler, a man of his word, no doubt?
Well, the Matador had wrestled me previously in a match. He was supposed to have taken the mask off. He was beaten. Troy Tyler stood up. He had his head shaved. And I think it showed almost the fighting spirits that the Arabs have.
I think the main thing that has gotten to me is this, Alan. In all my years of professional wrestling, I've got to admire Troy T. Tyler more than anybody. No one held him down to do this. He said he was a man of his word, and I really believe it should have been the Matador's mask instead of Troy's hair.
Les, I agree with you 100%. You're seeing right now that a man is willing to sacrifice anything he can because he's a trustworthy man. He's an honest man. You don't find that kind of person every day.
You certainly don't. Les Thatcher for Alan Williams and everyone here is saying, please join us again next week.
You've been watching Southeastern Championship Wrestling, voted the number one wrestling program by the Wrestling Writers Federation. Join us again next week for fast-paced action on Southeastern Championship Wrestling. Announcers on this program provided by Southeastern Wrestling Incorporated.